Hello there, people. This is Mr. Critic, and you're watching my Let's Replay of Panzer General. It's part 4, Norway part 2, Axis turn 4. Yeah. Before I begin, I just wanted to say two things. It was brought to my attention from very special viewer. Well, all of you are special, but talking about my dear friend Yip, who is always such a great source of information, that he does not like for me to show hidden units in the beginning of this of any scenario, actually. So, since I know that your opinions differ on that matter, that you, of course, want different things from an LP. This one we can settle so everybody is happy. So, from now on, before I turn, well, in the beginning of the scenario or close to the end, hidden units you know of, I will say that I will do this. And those of you who do not like to see hidden units, you know, can really just close your eyes or look away, since, you know, I won't be going into details where they are. Just showing here, here, that sort of thing. But I didn't realize it, so, yep, mein Freund, sorry, I didn't know, you know, just part of my Let's Play. But we can settle this, so, like I said, everybody will be happy. And the second thing I have to tell you, I'm an Aspie. Yeah, I know it's a pretty personal thing to share with you guys, but I took the test, and, well, I suspected it for quite some time, but I took the test, and yeah, officially I'm an Aspie. I'm pretty sure that at least Carl will say, well, duh. But on one hand, it is kind of frightening. On the other hand, at least I know why the hell I'm so obsessed, you know, with, well, Panzer General, for example. So yeah, I'm crazy. I knew it, you know, you also knew it, probably. Anyway, so like I said, it's Axis turn 4. We have made some progress so far. We didn't have problems with bad weather. Well, this turn we have overcast. Let us hope for, I don't know, not raining on the next turn. Yeah. But let us now start from the south. We'll take over the city of Oslo and its airfield with these two infantries, just in case there is some serious opposition here. We'll take over, you know, the airfield with our most experienced infantry, and Oslo with our least experienced one. Doesn't look that bad. Now for this inf, it will also come closer. It can cross the river Hex or go here. Don't think it makes much of a difference. So yeah, 1, 2, 3 in both cases. So we'll play it safely. Now for our naval units. We can see here, so we will advance with our destroyer. Okay. There is most likely a T-boat still in the city of Kristiansand. There is no way we can confirm this, unless of course we send a fighter over. Well, we cannot actually reach the city. Okay. But first let us deal with this inf and also gain more experience for our imps. So first we'll attack with our less experienced infantry. It's a bit loud, but I like it. we advance, well, wow, 2 stars. You see, this is how you get experience for your infantries. Attack. Nice. And what can we now do with our naval units? I wish we would be able to see what is hiding inside this port of Kristiansand. I believe there is, like I said, a T-boat here, and with the range of 4 we would be able to attack it if we would just be able to see it, you know, so let us wait for a while. First, we will take over the city of Stavanger. And this imp we can send. Directly. Well, if there is a T-boat inside the city of Kristiansand, I mean inside the port, then we will be. Stop that, not attacked, but still. I would like to think about it for a while. First, let us do the obvious things. We will advance with our destroyers and our heavy cruiser, and usually the enemy purchases an inf in the city of Bergen, so let us be careful about it. So here we go. Yeah, here it is. Attack. Bomber here. We can attack this inf. But as you have seen in the previous scenario, a British tactical bomber is in the area, and I'm fearing that Spitfire is also somewhere near. Although I'm surprised that it is not actually, you know, well, one hex away, you know, protecting this tactical bomber. So I'm really not sure what to think. Where the Spitfire could be. Okay, so perhaps the things that are very obvious first. This light cruiser has dared to approach us, and I think it's time for us to destroy it. True, this guy has a spotting of 3, but we will destroy it. And also, submarines are very difficult to spot if you are not next to them, even, you know, if they are in spotting range. This is one thing I forgot to mention when playing the let's play of this grand campaign for the first time, but it's also because I didn't really know it, you know. So I believe Tom told me what is the deal with the subs. So okay, now we attack this light cruiser. Spotting of 3, so nobody's really close. We can use now our own light cruiser and perhaps even destroy the enemy's light cruiser. Bingo. And we'll just move a little bit closer, since we want to support our sub if anything bad happens. Speaking of subs, we have to bring 2 more down, and we'll do just that. Once they are together with this group, and also when this group reaches them, then we may be in a position to actually challenge the Royal Navy. Until then, we'll play it, you know, slowly and safely. So first let us scout with this tank and of course advance. Spotting of two, okay. So at least one of our tanks will have to go south to assist, but not just yet. First we can advance here. What do we see? Nothing. Okay, so for the tactical bomber, we'll attack it. Says 06. Come on. Oh, firing at the same time. This really wasn't fair. I believe this tactical bomber, yeah, has an initiative of 3. We have an initiative of 5. And okay, but let us now destroy it. Just in case we'll box it in. Or maybe... Otherwise, you know, I'm all for boxing the enemy units in, but this costs us 4 additional fuel, and if we suddenly have problems with the Spitfire in the area, I want my fighters to actually be able to move, so let us do it like this. This really should work. Yeah. Took some, you know, risk, but it worked. Now for... now for the tactical bombers and this fighter around the city of Trondheim. First we'll attack this inf. An excellent result. Where can we move? We need fuel and ammo, most definitely, so perhaps here, and after we attack with our fighter, we move it here. Okay, now for the tank, we'll take over the airfield. Come on, firing at the same time, but we have won. Now what if we take over? Still, this unit still has an entrenchment of 5. What happens if we attack it with our tactical bomber? Says 01. You know what? Perhaps it is not such a bad idea. You know, to soften up this unit first. So, just in case. Come on. Oh, actually went too good. So now I'm not happy about this situation. Can we fly? Yeah, we can only protect one tactical bomber. So, since our Luftwaffe is our priority. Now, in gaining experience, we'll attack now this inf. Probably destroy it, and we have our tactical bomber near this airfield. So we'll get more, you know, fuel and ammo. Now we strafe this destroyer. Yeah, with an excellent result, not. Now we take over the city of Trondheim and also attack this weak destroyer. I mean this weaker destroyer, it's not really weak, but you know what I mean. What's our experience? 85. So if we can do some damage, we will be very close to 1 star of experience. Let us see what happens. Come on, come on, some good luck, please. No. Okay, now for these two tanks, you can come. Well, from here it's 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we are close enough. And you too. Probably time to save the game. So it's Norway. 009, and I believe this is it for the north, with the exception of these two paratroopers, which will advance north near the Swedish border. I'm just hoping they're not spotted, you know, and that there is Spitfire somewhere close. Ugh. Sometimes you just have to take a risk. Now, what I was thinking about when, when studying the battlefield, we have successfully crippled a Norwegian fighter that was stationed on this hex. Or I'm not sure, but the thing is that after a unit is crippled, it starts to go towards, you know, towards the closest airfield, if it is an air unit. And the closest airfield at the time was actually the airfield around the city of Trondheim. Since, you know, at the time, it was still in the Norwegian hands. So, with some luck, we might be able to find this unit. I'm pretty sure it's not like here or here, since, you know, it has, I don't know, I think it can fly for like 12 hexes, but still. Just to be very, very, very careful. Then, if you want, you know, you always just scout one hex at the time. Until, of course, you find the unit that you're looking for. Okay, getting closer and closer. Where is it? Am I missing something? There should be a Norwegian fighter in this area. Perhaps it went, well, more to the south? Oh, god damn it. Feel so stupid doing this, but there has to be a Norwegian fighter in the area. But where? Okay, maybe it went north. Gotcha, gotcha, bitch. Oh, sorry, I'm sorry. Okay, now we destroy it. Okay. So one more fighter is gone. Now what can we do if we want to also, you know, find I'm pretty sure that there is a T-boat in the city of Kristiansand, but what if there is an imp here and we approach, you know, with our land transport and damn it. Okay, let us think about this just a little bit later. First we can of course strafe this inf. Come on. Artillery. I was expecting an artillery here actually, so no surprise. Let us strafe this artillery as well. Again, no result. Now we are forced to do something in the south. Okay, let us take a chance. So this is as far as we can see. Please let there be a T-boat inside this city. Oh shit! Shit! Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, damn it. Not good. But now we cannot take, you know, back our movement, so. Okay, tactical bomber, please do some damage. Says 2, please do 2. Okay, even 1 is better than. Oh, okay, but now we can actually see why. We don't have a spotting of 2, and now suddenly we see. Now I'm puzzled. Is it because of our movement when approaching this port? Yeah, most likely. Okay, so at least now we can deliver some damage to this inf and also to this T-boat. So T-boat is only a threat to our destroyer, so we'll attack it with our heavy cruiser. Okay, 7. Spotting of 2. Okay, now we bring closer our battleship and kind of prevent this T-boat from actually, you know, kicking our butt here. So yeah, says 0-3. Good. Oof, I feel better now. Oh no, I don't. Still strength of 8. Eh. Lousy result. Okay, now we can focus on this inf. Don't want to destroy it, but I want to damage it a little bit, so. Okay, here we go. Still has a strength of 4. Yeah, I want to keep it alive for this infantry of ours, you know, to reach it and then take it out. So. Do we attack again? No, I don't think it's necessary. We cannot purchase anything. Now we'll save. It's Norway 010. What else? Well, plenty of prestige casualties, as you can see. Now let us give the enemy its turn and hope for, well, hope it doesn't rain. Or snow, or I don't know, but a lot of things can happen in Norway in April. I was told that when I was playing the first LP of Panzer General, so should we check weather report? Okay, overcast, dry for today and for tomorrow. Yeah, but I get a feeling that it will be raining. Okay, and Oh shit. Spitfire has appeared, but we have fired first. So this means we will not be destroyed, unless there is of course another fighter in the area. Oh, very good luck. Thank you. Again, we have fired first. Perfect. Now it's raining. Yeah. Well, we can't have everything, I guess. So let us save. It's Norway 011. And now I will take a little pause to study the battlefield. Be right back. Yo, I'm back. So, studying the battlefield a little bit. Well, what happened? We see a Spitfire now, but we cannot destroy it since it's raining. As for the ground map, well, we see more enemy naval units around the city of Trondheim. Still, because it's raining, we cannot do anything with Luftwaffe. We'll, of course, do some damage to them with our tanks. But one thing that is actually a blessing, now we can safely move our Fallschirmjäger towards the city of Narvik and, you know, other objectives in the north. And this is exactly what we'll do. You know, like immediately. So, here we go. Now we go to the south. I think we are in a position to take out this infantry. Come on. Well, you know, at least we have taken over the city of Kristiansand before, you know, the ground turns to mud, and then we'll have some serious problems now. Let us embark this inf, send it here, so it can advance along the west coast, take over the city of Bergen, and then, of course, join us around the city of Trondheim, eventually. This will take some time, however. So, where is the T-boat? Here or here, I would guess. So let us now scout. Oh, here we go. We'll attack. Well, perhaps this wasn't such a good idea, but we have two more ships in the area and we'll use them. Strength of 5, now for our battleship. Strength of 3, this means that even if this T-boat does attack our destroyer, we will not be destroyed. Which is good, you know, because destroyer just hates to be destroyed. And now we'll advance here. So this is the maximum. Now also another inf comes closer. As for the city of Honefoss, the entrenchment is actually 3. So, can we attack it, force it to retreat without exposing our units too much to this artillery? I think so. Says 1-6, we have 2 stars of experience. Shit! Strength of 7. Let us attack again. Says 1-4. The unit has retreated, and now we'll just take over this non-victory objective and not advance. We are in enough shit as it is, since this artillery can see our experienced inf. Okay, now for the fighters, I believe it's time to send them north. First, however, we will place our tactical bombers over the enemy destroyers. It is quite safe to do this, since of course the Spitfire cannot attack them. It is raining, so when it's raining for everybody. Okay, this tactical bomber can now, well, just advance north. Okay, now for another tactical bomber, you can go here. One fighter can go here. The rest of the fighters, well, one can move here. Okay, it was scouting. Two more fighters. One can move here. So now this Spitfire is totally boxed in. Two more fighters will join us here and here, because they are low on fuel. And the last of our fighters, I believe, will just move here. So we still have a movement of 13 available with the fuel. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, we can reach the airfield. And we are sort of in control of the situation, even though, like I said, I'm really not happy about what happened. Well, you know, around the city of Honefoss. Okay. What else can we do? Okay, more tanks. We could probably start attacking from behind by taking over the city of Donbass, since if the weather now turns too nasty, let us check the weather. Raining, muddy, damn it. It could help us, you know, to have a couple of tanks behind the lines to deal with this artillery and everything. So here we go. Carefully. Here. Here, okay. Attack. Two stars should work. God damn it. Well, it didn't work, but at least we weren't, you know, crippled or even annihilated. Now we'll attack this destroyer in the port of Trondheim. Usually when we do thing like this, the ship is scuttled, so let us hope it will happen again. Yes, we move here. Now we attack with our tank. This tank will now You know what I'm thinking, right? I feel like placing at least one of the tanks close enough to further assist with the city of Donbass. So if we move here, we have 2, 4, 5. But if the weather suddenly turns muddy, then even this range will be too much. I don't know. You can advance here. And you can advance here. So we are prepared for both situations. Muddy terrain or ordinary terrain, we can attack this imp twice. Either through the mountains or, you know what. Okay. What to do with this imp? We'll leave it be for a while. Let us now bring our subs even closer. So now we are preparing to join our two naval battle groups. First we'll again shell this imp. I mean, of course, bombard it. Move here, so we are still in range. And we'll attack it again. Just to be nasty. And now we'll leave it be, actually. Only keeping one destroyer close enough to spot this unit. And this will be our strongest destroyer. Spotting of two, yeah. These four naval units are the last to move, so let us just, move them for the purpose of moving. So, here, and here. Time to save. Yeah, should be Norway. 0-12. And give the enemy its turn and hope we will survive. Still raining. And now it's muddy. Bloody marvelous. You know the last time when I was doing the LP of Panzer General, this campaign, I was complaining about the snow and frozen ground, but this is actually worse. This is actually the worst thing that can happen to you when playing this game. When there is raining and the terrain is muddy. Nothing worse can happen. So now, I don't even want to, examine the terrain. Let us just finish off with this turn as soon as possible. Take a look at the battlefield. Just for you guys, air units, ground and naval units. No, Mr. Critic, come on, behave. The weather is nasty, but you shouldn't be. So, okay, time for a little pause. I will try to make the most out of this situation, but this will be our last turn, since I do not feel like doing two turns in mud. It just sucks. So, be right back. I'm back. What else to say? The weather is shitty, it's raining, it's muddy. Still, we have to make some progress, so let us start from the south, let us sink the steamboat and advance with our navy. Now we attack this imp. I don't feel like staying in the area, so we'll just move. Now we have also our heavy cruiser. And the imp is gone. And now our destroyer can advance. Here we will disembark our inf, but we will also bring our destroyer closer to the city of Bergen and attack it. I get the feeling, you know, that we will probably need some naval assistance to take over the city of Bergen if the weather doesn't improve, of course. Okay. I don't know. Do we need more than one destroyer in the area? Well, it all depends on the weather. So, who the fuck knows? Sorry. So now for our paratroopers, one will fly here. This city is empty, and this airfield is also empty. And now for Harstad, let us fly here. There is an inf inside, but when we disembark, we will probably land somewhere here. Okay. I really want to finish this turn, you know. Okay, back to the south, the city of Kongsberg. Okay, we bring one inf closer, carefully though, and not attack. Too risky. Yet another one is now closer. Or perhaps we can give it elite replacements, right? Since we are kind of taking our sweet time at the moment. And you get elite too, and you too. But with this imp, we can advance. Where to though? That's a good question. Oh, we have air units to scout, so why risk anything? Let us first bring our tactical bomber here. See what is going on. So, nothing is actually actively protecting this artillery, so we might as well. Whoa. My bad. Okay. Come on, kill this Norwegian inf. Very nice. We have one star. No, getting closer though. As for our air units, some of them will now immediately send south. But first, let me try if this works. We have two tanks with two stars of experience and one inf here, so says 1-3 and 1-3 again. So what happens if we attack head on? No. Oh, Mr. Critic, you're an idiot. But since you already know this, mountain. Still, we should be safe. We attack again with this tank. Come on, no rugged defense this time, please. Excellent. Very nice. And now I believe we can bring some of our fighters. Well, this one, for example, can fly here. Cannot attack, again a bug. But it is preventing this infantry from reinforcing. No, at all. One more fighter will fly here to scout. I see, so this is what is happening around the city of Lillehammer. Yet another fighter will now fly here. Or maybe tactical bomber should do it. Yeah, if the weather, you know, turns for the better. Okay. What else do we have in the air department? Okay, this fighter can now, yeah, it can fly south, since it will be replaced by this fighter here. So, fuel of 2, but now we will be refueled. 4 more air units to move. 2 tactical bombers, 2 fighters. Wow, this one is extremely low on fuel, so it can fly here. And for the rest, heavy cruiser, light cruiser, 2 destroyers. Yeah, we'll fly over the destroyers, I believe, and keep this fighter boxed in. Okay. Now for our naval units. Subs are approaching their buddies. And here we'll just probably stay put, or no, let us meet here. Okay, now for the important part. Our tanks should advance, and when they advance, they should also attack the enemy cruisers. So here we go. Ouch. We have 2 more tanks. Only one will advance, I mean attack and advance near the coastline, the other one will go here. Please do some damage to this cruiser. No. And you can move here. So yeah, we are kind of advancing, but now this is really... No. Well, we are almost at the standstill. A bit, I'm exaggerating a little bit, but like I said, raining and muddy terrain, the worst thing that can happen to you in Panzer General. Now we'll save, give the enemy its turn, and then we will finish this video. Most definitely, since I really do not feel like playing any longer. Yeah. Okay, enemy's turn. Oh, we're overcast. Lovely. Still muddy, but it's an overcast. Okay, let us study the battlefield. So this Spitfire will now be ours. Lovely. So it's not that bad any longer. Now we'll, of course, disembark our paratroopers, start working again on the enemy's navy, on the Royal Navy, bring our infantry closer. Yeah. I'm hoping this is it for bad weather. if it is, it is still much better than my dear friend and co-Elpior got his bullshit, don't you see, was facing. But I think he had enough of bad luck for both of us. So now let us save. Norway 0-15. Tomorrow I will most likely do yet another video of Panzer General. Perhaps even Panzer Corps. I cannot promise you anything. But one thing I can promise you about Panzer Corps, I will continue with the LP and finish it. My word, you know. So, okay. What else? Nothing. Thank you for watching this. All the best from Mr. Critic, and bye bye.